It's 5:54 on Saturday, the 14th, May 14th. And got an easy day today, just going to mile 192 or 194, somewhere in there, before tomorrow, which is a big downhill, like 6,000 feet downhill, all the way down to the desert floor. So easy day today, easy water carry because water's pretty plentiful coming off of San Jacinto in little trickles here and there, little streams. I probably won't have to get water for about 5 miles at the North Fork of the San Jacinto River, which is just like a little stream, but should be plenty of water and plenty cold. And today is just a beautiful, slow walk in the woods. One of my favorite times. Mountain chickadees are out singing. Thought about doing the summit, but I'm gonna stay on the PCT this time. I've summited before, and I've done pretty much every single trail. I did another little side trail yesterday, an alternate of the PCT, the Tawquich Valley trail. And so now I think I've done just about every single trail in the San Jacinto Wilderness because I've taken different routes each time. And it's going to be a great day. All right. First snow crossing. I guess I could go around it practically, but I don't anticipate a lot being this starting this late. But there's still a little bit of snow up here in San Jacinto. Little patches here and there. There. Successful.
Calling in the distance, so I packed my things and ran far away from all the trouble. I had cars with my two hands. Alone we traveled on with nothing but a shadow. We fled far away. Hold your head.
It's about mile 181 or so. It's about 8,900 feet up. I slept last night almost about 9,000 feet. It's colder up here. It's gorgeous. I found this quaint little spot to have breakfast. This morning's breakfast is a protein bar and some instant breakfast I'm going to add to water. It's a sacrifice because it has a pretty good view. The town of Idlewild is down there somewhere. Right in there somewhere, I believe. And that's Tawquich or Tawquich Peak over there. And a lot of rock climbers go to do that area there. PCT heads off around the western side of the San Jacinto Mountain. Absolutely beautiful spot.
Scars and some scratches made me wonder about their past. And as I looked around, I began to notice that we were not.
or so, and it occurred to me, if you're watching this and you're not familiar, there's different ways to find water sources or good places to, flat level places to camp, or how far it is to town and so forth. I use an app, it used to be called Gut Hooks, now it's Far Out. I also use Half Miles maps, they're harder to find, but I'll put a picture right here. So for example, the next spot I'm going to get water is North Fork of the San Jacinto River, and it's 3.6 miles ahead, and it shows me my elevation gain and descent from there, from this point to where that is. So 1,000 some odd feet of elevation gain, and I think 400 or so feet of descent. So you can plan out your water carries. You can read the notes and you can leave notes. It's a really good app. You can plan out your water carries and know if a stream or if a spring is flowing. Sometimes there's seasonal streams and springs that won't be flowing, and so you have to mark that, take a note of that, and make sure you're carrying enough water to get you to the next reliable water source. Up here in the San Jacinto Wilderness, not a problem. There's a little trickle coming down from the mountain every couple miles. In the desert, super important to know your next water source, so you can calculate your distance and how much water to use, and then you can calculate how much water you need to carry to get to the next water source. So, if you're wondering, that's how I do it. So I packed my things and ran, far away from all the trouble. I had cars with my two hands, alone we traveled on, with nothing but a shadow. We fled far away. Hold your horses now, sleep until the sun goes down, through the woods we ran, down. All right, just about 9,000 feet, I think about 8,700, and getting close to the North Fork of San Jacinto River. It's more like a little stream, but it's reported to be flowing really well. Getting some patches of snow here and there, but nothing concerning, and it's a great day. It's looking northwesterly. And that's the Mount San Gorgonio, the edge of it, which Big Bear's on the other side of it. I'll be there in 5 days or so. And then in the far distance is the area to Cajon Pass, and right there, with the snow on it, is Mount Baden-Powell. I'll be there in maybe 2 weeks. I hear the North Fork of the San Jacinto, which is my early lunch spot for the day. And the last water source until you get all the way down to the valley floor, just about. So I think it's the last water source for 26 miles or so. That's nice. About their past. And as I looked around, All right, mile 187.5 or so. Heading to down Fuller Ridge. Now to get to where I'm gonna stop for the night, it's 3,000 feet. It's over 3,000 feet of descent, and only like 300 more of ascent. So I just finished a nice long lunch, early lunch, for about an hour at the North Fork of San Jacinto River. Really nice place, a little waterfall there, and easy water, super cold, fresh, tastes great. And I'm loaded up with, I think, about 5 liters. Next water is down the very bottom, almost to the I-10, but at the bottom there's a faucet, strangely enough, and it's 19 miles away, so it's 19 miles to water, and it could get hot later on the day, and hot tomorrow going down the switchbacks all the way down. So I'll bring you along the trail with me for a second, and then put the camera away so I don't fall. Beautiful day in the San Jacinto Wilderness. I can't say enough how much I love this portion of the trail. I love a lot of the different biomes and regions and stuff of the trail, but I'd probably trade a lot for this section. It's just gorgeous. And that's where I'm headed. Tomorrow afternoon I'll be down there. Doing about 3,000 of it now, about 4,000 of it tomorrow. But about a 7,000 foot descent all the way to the bottom of the valley floor. We were nothing like the rest. All right, we're sitting here, mile 190.5 or so. And these wonderful people here have all brought are all up here for the weekend, I think, and they got a forerunner like mine, but better than mine, and they have offering us food and sodas, and so a little impromptu trail magic,
beer, tequila.
Oh my gosh, these guys are wonderful. So
and wine too,
and some rice and upside down cake, and so this is just amazing. Thank you guys so much.
We'll be in Kennedy Meadows on the 9th.
Yes, if you 9th, guys 10th, make it 11th. All the way there, we're going to be camping in Kennedy Meadows.
And the 9th and 10th? And
June. So you got that much time.
Man, I'm gonna try to book it. That's earlier than I'll get there, but I will try.
Yeah, because I guess that's one of the stops in Kennedy Meadows where you guys get your provisions. And all
Yeah.
So we're going to be pretty close to maybe the trail.
Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it. Hey, these are our trail angels. And we had food and rice and cake and sodas. These guys are super wonderful. There's a whole bunch of hikers sitting back here. Thank you guys so much. This was such an unplanned surprise. And yes, we hope to make the Kennedy Meadows for sushi. But thank you guys so much. And from the bottom of our hearts, we really appreciate you guys. This is wonderful. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Onward. So just had like an hour or more break at mile 191 maybe or so. This group of people with their forerunners and Tacomas and stuff all are for the weekend. They were calling themselves the Filipino Trail Angels, and they had ice cold soda and rice and pulled pork with onions and some, I think, like a Filipino squash. It was so good, and pineapple upside down cake. It was some of the best trail magic. Super nice people. Had a great conversation with them. They're in the video, obviously, before this. Super funny guys and ladies. It was so nice. Great conversation. Wow, I would love to see them again. So nice. Makes me want to quit the trail and go get my 4Runner and drive up here and join them. Because they go out all the time, I guess. And they're going to be in Kenny Meadows, like later on down the trail. But I don't think I can make it that soon. But if any of you guys are watching this video, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. That was totally wonderful. It's a nice stop. It was really hard to leave. Really hard. But so onward, a whole bunch of hikers were there too, hanging out. That's a little vortex, can be hard to leave because they're so nice and a good conversation. And so just beautiful people. And thank you guys so much.